What's good, YouTube? It's your boy JoJo Star, and today I'm gonna be giving you my list of five animes that you should watch this Halloween. Gotta take the mask off because I cannot breathe in this thing and it's barely staying on my face. I'm gonna be giving you five animes that you should watch this Halloween. I'm gonna try and give like a diverse list of like actual anime series and maybe throw a movie in there or two. So let's jump right into it.
Now, if you're anything like me, you probably have no outdoor plans for this Halloween. And due to what's going on in the world, it's probably best you're not accepting candy from random strangers. So, to cure your boredom that you have while in the house on this spooky night, here's my five takes on what scary, creepy, and just downright weird anime you should watch this Halloween. If the intro to this video wasn't a big enough hint for you, I'm gonna be starting my list with Tokyo Ghoul. Tokyo Ghoul is a great anime that has a heartwarming story, likable characters, good animation, and all the bloody and gore-filled scenes you could ask for. In the world of Tokyo Ghoul, there's what's known as ghouls, which are basically demons with incredible strength and powers, but here's the catch. They look just like humans, and they roam amongst them in their everyday lives. But their only energy source needed to survive is human flesh. The story follows this guy Kaneki, who goes on a date with this girl who he later finds out is a ghoul, only due to her trying to eat him. I guess they had different ideas in mind when they said, "Let's go out to eat." Kaneki survives this attack and wakes up in the hospital, only to realize that he was only able to survive by being transformed into half-human, half-ghoul hybrid. He struggles with the urges to eat humans in order to survive, while also dealing with the moral struggles of not wanting to be a cannibal, and also being half-ghoul without anyone he knows finding out. He finds this secret organization located in a coffee shop that's made up of other, non-evil ghouls who, without giving too much away, pretty much train him on how to use his powers and defend other humans against other ghouls. Not only will this satisfy your bloody and violent urges, but it comes with a captivating story that alongside the creepy and sadistic scenes will be enough to make you want to watch everything Tokyo Ghoul has to offer. Now, next on my list is Death Note. Now, if you haven't already seen Death Note, I have just one question for you. What the fuck is wrong with you? Death Note has an amazing story that's so good that I've never met anyone who wasn't a fan. It's so good, in fact, that I've watched the entire series 5 times, and I'm on my 6th as we speak. Not lying. Death Note is the intense, mind-blowing story of Light Yagami, a well-above-average high school senior with a passion for justice whose goal is to become a police detective like his father. One day, Light finds a notebook on the ground that previously belonged to a Shinigami, or God of Death. In short, the notebook allows the user to kill whoever they please just by writing their name in the note while picturing the victim's face. Light uses this as an opportunity to become a self-proclaimed god and rid the world of evil by killing off criminals at his leisure, under the name Kira, which is given to him by the people of Japan. Eventually, the police catch on to the killings but are unable to come up with any leads, so they bring on the world's best detective, L, who has solved every case he's ever been on. But the catch with L is, no one has ever seen his face or knows his real name, which is a big problem for Kira. Death Note is great if you want something different from just the simple violent killings but still hold the same level of intensity, if not more. The suspense alongside the creepiness of the Shinigami will have you on the edge until the last episode. And before I move on, don't think that you can just speedrun Death Note by watching the movie on Netflix, because as we all know, live-action adaptations on Netflix are fucking terrible, and Death Note was one of the bigger letdowns from Netflix, so we don't speak on that.
Hello YouTube, I am Kira. I will keep this short because I do not have much time, but if you do not subscribe to JoJo Star and drop a like on this video, I will write down all the names of every single one of you in my Death Note and kill you.
Wow, that was really weird to hear from Kira after bringing up you-know-who. I guess we really shouldn't talk about them. Anyways, next on the list is Gantz. This is next because after watching Death Note, your brain is probably fried from all that giga-brain detective work, so here's something you can just shut your mind off to and still be entertained. Now, for this entry, if you're a 2D drawn, animation-only type person, this may not be for you. Which is understandable, seeing as how 3D CGI animation in anime doesn't always work out. But if you don't mind taking chances with your viewing experiences, then here's something a little different for you. Now, as far as animation goes, I personally like this style when it's done right, which is why some of the Final Fantasy movies are my personal favorites. The story of Gantz follows a group of characters who have passed away and are put into this realistic game that requires them to fight various enemies such as demons and Shinigami. Now, the catch is, if they beat the game and their tasks are completed in under a certain amount of time, they're brought back to life. So original, right? Well, at least you know you're watching an anime. But what makes this a good watch is the fast pacing of events, fights, and again, this is just an opinion, but how good the film looks. Gantz looks so good that at times you'll be wondering to yourself if you're watching a live action or an animation. Not to mention, the soundtrack alone is enough to draw you in and take a deathly grasp of your attention. Now, I know this is a top 5 anime list, but I thought it'd be good to throw a movie in there, because it is Halloween, and who has time to watch an entire series in one night? definitely not me. Now, if you're into Greek mythology at all, you can just go ahead and skip to the next entry on this list, because you'll automatically like Blood of Zeus, and there's no point in convincing you to watch something that you're probably already queuing up on your playlist as we speak. Now, for those that need a little more of a push than just hearing the word Zeus or Greek gods, then listen up. Let me just say that first, I haven't actually seen Blood of Zeus in its entirety yet, but I have seen the first episode, and the rest of the series is what I'll be watching tonight while I ignore the germ-infested little fuckers that try to ring my doorbell tonight. So everything I'm about to say is in the first episode, so don't even complain about any spoilers. So we're following this poor guy in his village just trying to make ends meet when he finds a random bitch who he thinks is dead floating in the fountain when he encounters a demon and is attacked. Once he learns the story of how demons came to be, he goes off on a quest to learn the truth about his real father. And that's all we really got for the first episode. I'm not gonna lie, when I first saw that Netflix had an original anime series that was number 3 highest rated show on the app, I couldn't believe it, because I thought either Netflix had done something right with anime for once, or this was just another generic trash show made for normies so they could say they like anime. Now, as far as my opinion, just judging off the first episode, I can say that it isn't for me, but that doesn't make it bad. It's number 3 on Netflix for a reason. Obviously, some people out there like it. I'm just not one of those people. It just didn't do it for me, but I felt it'd be good to include a take like this on the list to make it more well-rounded and give some diversity. And I will be finishing it just because it's only 8 episodes and I want to give it a fair chance. Now, personally, I feel like Netflix just slapped the word anime on an American cartoon about Greek lore, because I feel anime is very distinct in its visuals and it's easy to tell apart from other styles of animation. But if I were to have seen it without no context whatsoever, I would have just assumed it was a cartoon. Not saying that's a bad thing, because since it was done by Netflix, it's safe to assume that the finished product would have a more American or Western type style to it. The closest thing I could compare it to is Avatar The Last Airbender, in the sense that some people debate that it's anime and others say it's not. So if you like that type of stuff, added with some demons and the rage of Zeus and other Greek gods and goddesses, you should check it out, because you might like it. Finally, we have Berserk, and I'm talking about the version from 97, because you should definitely watch that one first to get an understanding of the story. And also because the 2017 version isn't the greatest in terms of animation, a different studio got a hold of the rights than the 97 team and decided to go for a 3D CGI approach to it, which I'll let you make your own opinion on that. But as a whole, all that's lost is the animation, which is a pretty big part, but just hear me out. If you're coming off the 97 version or you're just a fan of the story, then you'll be able to get over that and enjoy what you can. I mean, it could be a lot worse. You could be watching 7 Deadly Sins. Berserk follows my man Guts, who is pretty much a badass mercenary roaming the lands in hopes of finding a challenge to give his life some meaning. I feel you there, man. Basically, Guts takes no L's, as he's known as the 100 Man Slayer, or later known as the Black Swordsman. He even becomes more of a badass, as if he wasn't cool enough already. He then finds a group of mercenaries following their leader, Griffith, who seems to have all the sauce in the land. The ladies love him. Griffith beats Guts in a battle and breaks him to the point where Guts joins up with them. Eventually, Guts learns about Griffith's dream to become king and spread his sauce all over the land.
Wait a minute. Wait, first of all, you're not gonna speed past that like you didn't just say what you just said.
Pause. He will do anything to achieve his dream. Fast forward to what's known as the eclipse, and without spoiling anything, this is where shit gets real. Everything changes now. There's all types of demons, gods, and creatures you wouldn't have expected up until this point. After the eclipse is over, Guts gets separated from the group and now has what's known as the Brand of Sacrifice, which is pretty much a symbol that attracts demons to him wherever he goes, so he's constantly being followed by these demons trying to kill him, all while trying to get back with the members of the group and find out why and what caused this all to happen. The story alone was enough to make me a fan no matter what I thought of the 3D animation, and I should probably mention that Berserk is definitely a mature anime and not for the faint of heart or mind. Also, the manga is rated 18+. Now, I'm not your parent, so I can't tell you not to watch it, but just don't say I didn't warn you. And that's gonna do it for this video, guys. If you enjoyed this type of video, let me know with a comment. Hopefully you enjoyed and added at least one of these anime to your watch list, or at the very least, enjoy me as some background noise while you, I don't know, eat yourself into a candy coma this evening. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And happy Halloween.